Hi friends, myself Sanjay Patil, and today we are going to discuss environmental management, that is the unit 6 of sustainable development. Now the contents of this presentation are need for environmental management, then purpose of environmental management framework, that is EMF, then methodology adopted for EMF preparation, then application of the environment management framework, then awards in environmental management, and finally people perception about environment. Okay, so let's have a discussion on need for environment management. Good environmental management practices are essential and integral element of sound project preparation and implementation, and therefore an environment management tool would be needed for preventing or overcoming environmental issues encountered during the various stages of the project, right from planning, designing, construction, operation. Such a tool should be prepared with an intention to strengthen the intended outcome from the proposed project or program. So now, till now we have seen that sustainable development is related with environmental issues. Okay, and if we want to set up or if we want to start a new project, then we have to study the various environmental issues related with the various phases of the project, like planning, designing, construction, operation. Okay, so what will be the impact of that particular thing, that we have to study. Okay, and for that purpose there is a need of environment management. Then purpose of environment management framework. First one is establish clear procedures and methodologies for environmental planning, then review, approval and implementation of sub-projects to be finalized under the project, which we have discussed just now, to provide practical guidance for planning, designing and implementing the environmental management measures, then specify appropriate roles and responsibilities and outline the necessary reporting procedures for managing and monitoring the environmental and related social concerns of sub-projects. Sub-project mean the project will divided into number of things or mini projects. It will be called as sub-projects. Then finally, determine the institutional arrangements, including those related to training, capacity, building and technical assistant needed to successfully implement the provisions of EMF. And final purpose, support the integration of environmental aspects into the decision making process of all the stages related to planning, designing, execution, operation and maintenance of sub projects by identifying, avoiding and or minimizing the adverse environmental and social impact early on the project cycle. So we have to study the environmental impacts during the various projects of the various phases of the project, and we have to take the proper preventive action for that. And for that purpose, environmental management framework has to be established. Then methodology adopted for EMF preparation. Preparation of checklist for collecting project related information against applicable guidelines and for conducting a limited environmental assessment. Now checklist can be used as a tool, and we have seen how to prepare checklist in our last presentation. So it can be used as a tool for environmental assessment. then review of land allocation documents, then permits and other relevant documents. That is the next step. And then sample field-based examinations to identify if these standards and codes are used in site development, construction and operation of building facilities and technologies of tool rooms or technology centers. Then identification of good practices and environmental issues faced in the existing technology centers. Then formal interviews on the sample basis with the stakeholders. So for a particular project, we have to find out stakeholders. We have to discuss with them various problems, various environmental issues, how to overcome that particular environmental issues, and we have to come with certain remedies. Then preparation of draft of EMF, then presentation and disclosure of the draft EMF to stakeholders, and to seek the feedback from the stakeholders if at all there are some corrections, that then correction has to be done, and finally the finalization of the EMF. So that is the procedure to draft a EMF. Then application of the environment management framework. Environmental management framework includes the following, that is information on Government of India's environmental legislations, standards, then World Bank safe policies, safeguard policies and other international conventions policies that is relevant in the overall project context. Then next application is process to be followed for environmental screening to guide decision making about proposed sub projects. That also can be used, or the data of that environmental management framework can be shared. Then steps and process to be followed for conducting environmental impact assessment and preparation of environmental management plans for selected sub project. Now what is environmental impact assessment, EIA, that we have seen in our last presentation. And after assessing the EIA, next stage is to establish the environment management framework for the project. And last application is preliminary assessment of anticipated environmental impacts in the context of broad or known project interventions. So these are the various applications, or the environment management framework data can be used in these various aspects. Then awards in environmental management. So in India, in Indira Priyadarshini Vriksha Mitra Award or IPVM awards are given by the Ministry of Environment and Forest of Government of India to individuals and institutions who have done pioneering and exemplary work in the field of afforestation and wasteland development. Afforestation development means establishing forest or plantation of tree. Okay, then a cash award of ₹2,50,000 is presented to individuals or institutions in 7 categories. So they have established, or they have found out the 7 categories and awards are given. Then it was instituted in 1986 and were given annually. Initially, IPVM awards are given in 12 categories till 2006, but as per 2012 notification of Ministry of Environment and Forest, 7 categories are approved for this particular award. So this award is related with इंडियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट एंड फॉरेस्ट, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। देन लास्ट पॉइंट, पीपल परसेप्शन अबाउट एनवायरनमेंट। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस डिस्कशंस और इन आवर प्रीवियस प्रेजेंटेशन वी हैव सीन रिलेशन बिटवीन पॉवर्टी एंड एनवायरनमेंट और द पीपल परसेप्शन अबाउट एनवायरनमेंट, हाउ दे आर रिलेटेड विद एनवायरनमेंट। ओके, सो नाउ पीपल परसेप्शन कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री टाइप्स और थ्री कैटेगरीज, लाइक रीजन स्पेसिफिक परसेप्शंस, देन इनकम स्पेसिफिक परसेप्शंस एंड जेंडर स्पेसिफिक परसेप्शन। नाउ रीजन स्पेसिफिक परसेप्शन, टेक अ एग्जांपल ऑफ अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज। सो द पीपल लिविंग इन अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज, दे आर टोटली डिपेंडेंट ऑन एनवायरनमेंट, सो देयर परसेप्शन इज डिफरेंट देन पीपल लिविंग इन यूरोप एंड अदर कंट्रीज। ओके, इनकम स्पेसिफिक परसेप्शन, सो वी हैव वी कैन कैटेगराइज द इनकम ऑफ पीपल लाइक मीडियम क्लास, हाई क्लास। ओके, एंड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दिस इनकम स्पेसिफिक, द नीड ऑफ द पीपल आर डिफरेंट। सो यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल रिसोर्सेस दैट आर डिफरेंट, राइट। And finally, gender-specific perception, that is male-female, their perception about the environment. So, just these points we have discussed in our earlier presentation, just for the sake of revision, we are discussing here. Okay. So, that's all from my side. Thank you.